guys, what's up? It's me, MJ Fangirl, and guess what? I'm married. In today's video, I'm gonna be giving you guys a little sneak peek into our wedding. If you guys are new here, my husband and I met each other as MJ fans on the Michael Jackson AOL chat room many, many years ago, developed a friendship and fell in love, and we just got married this past month, and I'm super excited to share the day with you guys. It is going to be an epic celebration of love, as well as, you know, some Michael Jackson sprinkled in there. Stay tuned, you don't want to miss it. You are now watching MJ Fangirl TV. Girl, you got All right, you guys, so if you have not seen my face before, my name's MJ Fangirl. I usually do videos for and about the Michael Jackson fan community. I do a lot of reaction videos. I do a lot of merchandise reviews, Michael Jackson news chats, travel vlogs, event vlogs, vlogs with all my MJ fan friends, you name it. Subscribe and hit the notification bell so that YouTube lets you know every time I post. I promise you won't miss a video that way. So I was never one of those girls that always dreamed of like my perfect wedding day. I didn't know really anything about how I wanted my wedding day to go. It was only until I met my husband and we developed our relationship and got engaged that I really started thinking about like how I wanted my wedding day to be and our wedding day to be. And this was gonna be really special because, if you guys did not know, I'm originally from New York City. We just actually moved to Los Angeles a couple of months ago. So this is really the first time that our families are gonna get to see me here in LA. Our families are gonna get to meet. Our friends are gonna all come and celebrate with us. So it was a really, really big day for us. And yeah, I'll just start off by saying that if you guys are interested, I definitely want to share with you guys how the process of trying on my dress and deciding all the details went down. So if any of you guys out there are wedding planning, or any of you guys are just interested in that, let me know and I can do a whole like full wedding planning video so I can catch you guys up on how I decided all the details. So you guys, the day got started very, very early because we actually had a brunch wedding. We got married at 10 a.m. in the morning. So I had a bridal party of, we each had three groomsmen and three bridesmaids, flower girl and a ring bearer. So all the ladies and I had to start getting our makeup done pretty early, and I think we started at 4 a.m. But you know, it actually kind of started at 4:15, 4:20. You know, your girls were a little sleepy getting up that early, but we started our makeup. It took a little bit longer than we expected, so I ended up actually getting to the venue like literally 2 minutes before I had to walk down the aisle. Thankfully, all of our friends and family were so prompt. They were already there, actually. If you check out my friend Gadget Trisha's video on her channel, I Love the Jacksons Family, you guys would see that I actually walked in and all of the guests were already there, like in the lobby area. I had to go there to get to the bridal suite. I actually had been planning to get to the bridal suite like 30 minutes before the wedding at the very least. Was hoping for an hour before, but hey, everything happens for a reason. Everything turned out amazing, so I couldn't have asked, honestly, for a better start. So when we got there, I had like 10 minutes to get dressed. We met up with our photographer, and I didn't even have time to like be nervous or anything, you guys. Like, I just had to go, go, go. We had done a rehearsal the day before, so we were all set. And my dad walked me down the aisle. For those of you guys who have watched my channel before, you guys know that my dad is a huge Michael Jackson fan as well, and so he's been on the channel. I've interviewed him once or twice, and so that was a really big special moment for me to have my dad walk me down the aisle. You know, there was a point in time when I wasn't sure if any of my family would be able to make it, but thankfully most of us, if not pretty much everybody at the wedding, was fully vaccinated, so it was a really, really huge relief to be able to finally gather with people again and have a lot of my older family members there. So you guys probably want to know, how did I incorporate Michael Jackson into the ceremony? Well, the bridal party actually walked down to a piano version of I'll Be There. I'm gonna put all the songs and everything in the description box so you guys can check those out. I chose to walk down to Canon in D, which is a classical song, and I wanted to walk down to something very classic, something memorable, something non-Michael Jackson. You know, I know that that would have been so expected for us to have had a Michael Jackson song for me to walk down the aisle to, but for me, I wanted to just have something special for us always to remember when we heard that song in the future, and I chose to go with a classical song. So yeah, this is the moment that I walked down the aisle. And when all of it was said and done, we did amazing. We had an amazing ceremony and an awesome officiant. He was he said so many powerful words. We exchanged our own personal vows, which was like super duper special. And then they pronounced us husband and wife, and we had our kiss moment. And we walked out to You Rock My World, and then the party began. So now I'm gonna show you guys some actual clips from the wedding, and I'm gonna talk you guys through how it went. So let's watch. All right, you guys, here we go. This is our big entrance into the reception. Here we got the MJ crew, the Moonwalkers. And you guys, we wanted to come in to Don't Stop Till You Get Enough because that's just like the ultimate party song.
Reach out my hand to you. I have faith in all you do.
Our cake topper, you guys, we got it from Etsy. It looks just like us. We had them customize it so that my husband's hair would be red like it is in real life. So here we are actually getting ready to cut the cake, and everybody's around there trying to take pictures. And our coordinator is explaining to us exactly what to do and how to time it so people can get the right pictures. So here we are with our really pretty knife. And watch what happens, you guys. Watch what happens. Bam. Can you see? The knife actually broke as we were cutting. So we had to cut with the blade down. But we played it off. We know what to do. Oh, here are all of our MJ fan friends getting ready to take a picture here. We were just so excited that our Moonwalker friends could be there. Comment down below if you recognize some of them. I know you do. Here's our group photo. And my girl, honey. She wasn't in the other one, so I was like, I gotta get her in there too. Okay, you guys, this was the surprise of a lifetime. You guys, I was shook. My husband surprised all of us, myself, and the entire bridal party guests, everything, with a Michael Jackson and tribute artist, and I was so surprised, you guys. This is One Glove Entertainment, and he did such a good job, y'all. People were on their feet watching like it was a mini concert. Check his performance out.
Michael! Michael!
Let me fill your heart with joy and laughter. Togetherness, one is all I'm after.
So I remember a time before Greg met Aisha. He was a smooth criminal.
I'm done.
Lonelier than a stranger in Moscow. Wandering the halls of the Heartbreak Hotel. Since then, he's taken a look at the man in the mirror to become a better man. And he wasn't gonna stop until he got enough. The day he told me he was getting married was a thrill. Blur. Great. You guys are wonderful, by the way. Both of you really are. I watched our love grow through those conversations that I talked about. It was unbreakable. Greg had found his PYT. And the rest was history. Enjoy yourself.
Enjoy yourself for me.
Right. And if the drink gets too much, blame it on the boogie.
All right, you guys, so here is the daughter-father dance with my dad, and we danced to Stevie Wonder, as one of his favorite artists is Stevie Wonder, besides Michael Jackson. And you guys, why did my uncles photobomb us, or like steal the stage, basically? They came on and started taking close-up pictures of us. It was actually a really funny and cute moment, so shout out to my uncles. They're all the lives of the party.
Thank you.
All right, you guys, here we go with the Soul Train line. We had an amazing wedding. It couldn't have been more perfect. And we're just so excited that you guys got to share in our special day. All right, you guys, so that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the wedding video. Leave your comments down below what your favorite part of the night was. I really, really wanted to include all the music for this, you guys, so I'm not gonna be having any monetary income from this, but I am gonna have a little special sale. If you do wanna support the channel, make sure that you guys use the code WEDDING on any of my merch down below, and you can get yourself 25% off. Thank you guys so much for watching the wedding video. I'm super duper happy that my friend Trish recorded this. Like, she is a lifesaver. Go and subscribe to both of her channels. Gadget Trish, as well as I Love the Jackson Family. And if you're vegan, subscribe to our vegan channel, Green is the New Lean. Thank you guys so much for watching. And also, if you want to know about more of the planning and all that, I also have footage of me trying on dresses and deciding and coming to the one that I actually decided, as well as everything, coming down to the makeup, the veil, everything. I would love to share that if you guys want to hear about it. So leave me a comment down below, and I'll see you guys next time. More videos to come, all Michael Jackson. Bye.